Content creation approval process. Quite a mouthful, and there's a lot happening when you are creating content on a regular basis, no matter if it's for yourself or for a client. There's a lot of steps and a lot of approval and a lot of things going on. So today I want to show you three easy tips how you can simplify your content creation approval process. Hey everybody, I'm Yvonne Hyman with AskYvi.com, and I am a business efficiency consultant for digital entrepreneurs. And today we are talking specifically about content creation approval process. Before we dive into the nitty gritty and the three tips I have for you to make your content approval process really easy, I want to talk about content approval process in general. Are we talking internal? Are we talking external? What the heck is happening? With that, today I want to talk about internal content approval process, meaning this is you working with your team, not the client. We are leaving the client out of all of this for right now. I really just want to talk about the internal content approval process between you and your team. Doesn't matter if you are building content for yourself or if you're building content for your clients. As you know, when it comes to the actual client approval process, that's when I usually bring in Agora Pulse, and we'll be talking about that whole process in another video. So, internal content approval process. Yes, I said I have three easy tricks, and I promise you it really is easy. Before I show all of them to you, pop in the comment section and let me know, do you have an existing approval process right now? And hit that subscribe button to join the conversation right here on my channel. Now, tip number one, really easy, have approved status. Now, if you look right here in my own ClickUp, you have seen these statuses before if you followed the channel. We have the to-do, in progress, waiting external, waiting internal, proof, and complete. It really can be this easy of just having a proof status. And please, 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 do not build 1,000 different statuses. Keep them simple. You should not have more than 3 statuses. For active work, you're not gonna need more. But I digress. In this case, what that means is you have a status, meaning an activity right here that says, okay, when I take this task and I move it into proof, you need to check this. You need to approve it, you need to look at it, you need to proofread it, you need to look at the image, whatever your process says to do in the status. That simple. Tip number one, set up a proof status. Now, the downside of this is there is not much customization. What does proof mean? And what if you have multiple team members or multiple stages in that proofing process? That's where tip number two comes in. Now, right in here, this is an agency setup with, I think they're running about 150 employees right now and some quite major big clients. This is a big setup. As you can see right here, they are using the same statuses you've just seen, but they have taken it to the next level. Their proof status tells them this specific piece of content needs to be proofed. But what does that mean? That's where the stages come in. So tip number two, to simplify your proofing process, have your stages ready. And we do have the status versus stages video if you are not up to speed what that all means. Right here, we have the drop-down field specifically set up for their graphic content creation workflow. And when you look down here, there is specific revision and review stages, which is their proofing, meaning it needs to be reviewed by Robin. Sweet, there is a stage for that, and you can base automations right on that. When this gets marked stage review Robin, you automatically can assign Robin to this task because she needs to review it. Same with review QA, or CM. Again, you can automatically assign the person that needs to review it. Big agency, they have multiple review stages, which is why this has been set up this way. So you easily can just choose for Robin to go check out that piece of content, review it, approve it, or send it back into the workflow. Now you're like, cool, Yvi, there's a whole bunch of stuff going on. Status, proof status, really easy because I really just work with one VA. You drop it in there if it needs to be proved. It's me. If I pop it back into in progress and reassign my VA, things are taken care of. We also got it covered if you're working with a bigger team, if there's multiple review stages going on, just use the drop-down field.
All good.
But what are we doing with actual visual content? How are we leaving notifications? How are we telling the team what the heck to do with it? Did you know that ClickUp has a feature for that? Yes? No? Let me know in the comment section. And while you're down there, don't forget to subscribe. Now, let me show you if you didn't know. When you have attachments to your content creation task, so we approach content creation usually as one piece of content is one task. Now, when you look at this piece of content right here and you scroll down, you're going to see that we have visual content attached to that. Now, visual content trying to pinpoint and just type over here what needs to be changed can be quite confusing and trying to figure out, and people are just guessing. Don't ever assume, especially not with visual content creation. So with that, you can click into that visual piece of content. And by the way, if you missed Leap Into Life, you really missed out. We had so much fun on that summit, but I digress again. You can comment on these visual pieces of content. So tip number three, use comment features right on your visual pieces of content for your approval process. Meaning your VA sent this graphic to you, cool, but you know what? Dave just looks a little bit crazy. I want a different, if I can type, different headshot. It's probably still spelled wrong, who cares? And I literally just plug that comment right on his nose. Visually, I know where that change needs to happen on this piece of content. And now I have it over here. You can now assign that to whoever. Let's not get everybody crazy, so let's assign it to me. Done. Now what happens with this? You can leave how many ever comments you want in here. All cool. But where do we take it from here? It now gets added as a comment on the actual task. And not only that, if you give it a second, it will even link that specific piece of visual content to your comment. So you easily can open it up again and you are not trying to figure out which pieces of attachments you left the comment on, right? Cool, we got that one. That comment is a checklist item of you need to change something here. So the combination of specifically telling somebody on that image, on that visual piece of content, I need this changed, I need that changed, I need that changed, in combination with the proof status of, hey, can you prove this? Is this spelled right, spelled wrong, whatever we need to do, or moving it then back into in progress and reassigning your VA to get it fixed. There you go. There's your tip number three of easily creating a content approval process right here in ClickUp. Now, as I said, this is how we handle content approval internally. As personally here at Ask Yvi, we are actually using the combination of the proof status with the stage of proofing with a couple of tricks and tweaks in there, as well as the commenting feature on visual content attachments right here in ClickUp. Now pop in the comment section, let me know which features in ClickUp are you using for internal content approval process, and stay tuned. Remember to subscribe because I'm gonna show you soon how we use Agora polls for our client content approval process. And I'll see you there.